Okay, we're going to do the logarithm product rule, and this applies to regular, base logs as well as the natural log. They both go. So let's just dive into it. I'm going to give you a log here. There's really no point to this problem other than teaching you, getting you used to it. You might have to do this one, but this is one of those instructional purposes only type thing. All right, well, let's take 35 and let's just write it into some factors, okay? And let's go. Log 7 times 5. Well, here's my product rule up here, and it says that I can go log A plus log B if I do that. So let me go ahead and do that right here. I took 35, I just broke it down, and now we have okay. Now, there's really nothing more we can do with this. This is as simple as it gets, okay? Because 4 raised to what power equals 7? Well, it's going to be some wacky number, some irrational number. So, but this is just an example of using the product rule, okay? So let's go ahead and we're going to just do some examples using the product rule. And one that comes to mind here, let's go. That's a y in parentheses. Okay, log x plus log y. Well, what is that? Okay, cool. All right. Let's do. I told you this will apply to natural logs as well. So what's this gonna end up being? Well, this one, we can actually use the logarithm power rule, okay? And what we'll end up doing on this is we're gonna take this 1/2 and we're gonna go stick it up there. It'll actually become an exponent of the y now. And I don't think I covered that. I haven't covered that yet. I might have lightly tapped on it, but I'm gonna give you a crash course in the logarithm power rule. Sometimes it's good to have a crash course. So this is going to end up being natural log of y to the 1/2 plus natural log of x. Now what I could also do is I could do this. I could also say natural log of square root of y plus natural log of x. Now since I have a sum of logs here, a sum of natural logs, I can take it a step further. And I can say natural log of square root y times x. And the x is, it's not in the radical sign. So that's a deal where I did that, okay? Next is, it's kind of the same animal, but not really. I'm just gonna go, I'm going to log b of a divided by b. Okay, this is the quotient rule. And this is simply equal to notice how these kind of look similar to the exponent rule. You know, like a or x to the a minus b is equal to x to the a over x to the b up there. OK, Kinda. Does anyone kinda notice that? If you did, pat yourself on the back. If not, don't worry about it. I didn't notice it either. Okay, but this is the quotient rule for logs. I'm just kidding, I actually did notice it. So let's dive into one of these examples real quick. And we're just gonna use, we're gonna do the same thing. It's just basically a division problem. Logarithms, really, they're exponents. That's what they are. So let's go log. This looks kind of wacky. That one looks kind of wacky. All right, so we got that. Log base 7, 19 over x. Okay, well, that's just going to be... That's where you are right there. Again, you can... You're probably going to want to leave it in this form. Like, I mean, it's 7 raised to what power is going to give you 19? Well, it's going to be a really weird one. So, and anybody can type it into the calculator. So, and really, we don't really care what it means anyway. Unless we're doing some stuff, some scientific stuff. When I do chemistry, I'll show you, you'll actually use that, because we'll do a lot of things with it. So, okay, but that's where it is. And just for, I don't know, just for the heck of it, we'll throw a natural log in there. Well, that's just equal to e, or natural log of 2 minus natural log of 8. And if you want to take it a step further, we can use our power rule in backwards method. You know? And then we have 2 times natural log of e minus natural log of 8. Okay, and if you think about it, e raised to what power gives you e? Well, e raised to the 1 gives you e. Okay, so we actually can simplify this a little bit further. And bada bing, bada boom, you got natural log of 8. So, that's a pretty good one right there. And I think that pretty much that covers some stuff. And let me go ahead and throw the power rule here. I didn't formally introduce it. I've thrown it in here twice so far without really telling you anything about it. But anytime you have an exponent wrapped up in here, you can take the exponent out and bop-a-bop-a. So if you had natural log of 64, you could rewrite it as natural log of 8 squared, and then you could go 2 times natural log of 8, okay? And repeat that process. So you got a couple deals like that. So, not too bad. That's the other 3 rules. So let's, the next video, we'll combine them is what we're going to do.